Is college really the best 4 years of your life? Going to parties, setting your own schedule, and enrolling in interesting classes are just some of the ways young people enjoy the experience. But what happens when you can't afford to go anymore? This scenario is all too real for some students. One of these stories is Mev Bakoya, who stopped receiving financial aid midway through college.
For my freshman and sophomore year, when I did have financial aid, I felt like there was a weight lifted off my shoulder just because I did have that knowledge in the back of my mind that school was paid for, that I didn't have to stress as much, that my parents didn't have to stress as much to help me, that they didn't have to overwork themselves. And then once financial aid got cut for me, I was actually working 3 jobs. I was working about 72 hours a week on top of going to full-time school just because I had that burden and stress that I didn't want my parents to help me pay for school.
Bakoya is currently a graduate student at DePaul University in Chicago. She received financial aid her first 2 years of undergraduate studies at DePaul, but when junior and senior year rolled around, her aid was cut off.
It was based on my parents' income since I lived with them, and so they assumed that my parents made enough money. And so even though it didn't change throughout the years, it was just for some reason my junior and senior year, they just believed my parents made too much money and they didn't want to offer any support or help.
Financial aid decisions are made by the U.S. Department of Education through a form commonly referred to as FAFSA, which stands for Free Application for Federal Student Aid. Filling it out can be confusing for many prospective college students, including Bakoya, who needed the help of her older sister.
She actually helped me fill it out as opposed to a counselor at school or my parents, just because we're first generation, so my parents don't really understand how the school system works.
Bakoya's sister also went to DePaul University for her undergrad. However, she was awarded financial aid all 4 years. For Bakoya, having to deal with the financial burden of several thousands of dollars of debt has completely changed her undergrad and graduate school experience, and she's not alone. The Federal Reserve says 30% of all U.S. adults have some form of debt from their education. The average student graduates from college owing $30,000, and student loan debt is predicted to increase to $2 trillion by 2022.
I'm paying for grad school with a little bit of a scholarship from DePaul, but no financial aid, and so it's a struggle because I'm not making enough money working to pay off school, and so it's hard because trying to maintain a social life with my friends where they're even struggling to pay for college, it's like we can't really do anything. We're spending all our money on books, on tuition, and just kind of overworking ourselves. I'm very adamant about people knowing their resources, knowing where to sign up for scholarships and how to apply for financial aid.
For those who don't have a friend like Bakoya to offer input, it can be quite confusing to learn how to make the right financial decisions. Laura Sherman, a sophomore at Indiana University, does not receive financial aid assistance and is not alone in wondering how the process works.
I kind of wish I knew more about it, just to know more about the college process in general, especially with scholarships as well. If it doesn't have to be talked about, it's just not talked about, even though it is such a big part of the college process. But again, because I'm lucky enough not to need it, I don't need to know anything about it.
Having different financial backgrounds at college is inevitable. However, the majority of college students do receive some sort of financial aid. During the 2016-2017 academic year, 85% of students attending a four-year university received some kind of financial aid, according to the National Center for Education Statistics. Yet, as Sherman pointed out, many young people don't understand how financial aid works and the full list of resources offered, including scholarships, grants, work study, and loans. Mike Bartini, director of student aid at Bowdoin College in Maine, says it's important to seek out help and have these conversations before applying to college so people fully understand what they may owe.
There are concerns throughout the country regarding the cost of higher education and the limited opportunities for financial aid. The sooner families start talking about college and how they're going to pay for college, the better. What we try to emphasize to families when they come our way is that this is not a 10-minute drill. Picking a college and preparing for how to pay for it takes time. And so we try to emphasize to families that take your time, think about what a good choice, what a good match for you is academically, and then figure out the best way to pay for it.
Martini is a vital resource to many prospective college students and their families, helping to break down the cost of attendance.
My advice to students is always, at the beginning of the process, spend the necessary time to find the institution or set of institutions that meet your academic goals. And then within those institutions, make sure that you have a set of institutions that you can afford financially. We do offer many opportunities for students and their family to engage in a conversation with us throughout the application process. And if they enroll during the time they are spending at the college, if a student family wants to have a conversation about their particular set of circumstances, we will make it happen. We think it's important that all families have an opportunity to talk about the cost of education and how they're going to pay for it. And if there's any way we can help them, we try to help them pre-enrollment and post-enrollment.
Martini says that without financial aid, it wouldn't be possible for many students to attend college. Helping people navigate how to make this a reality is one of the best parts of his job.
Our recent graduation reminds me of the many students who could not have attended the college without our support. And to watch them take the next step in their life, whether it be graduate school or their first job, is very satisfying.
Graduating from college is a major life achievement, but it's hard to celebrate if you're burdened by thousands of dollars of debt that could have been avoided. Before accepting an admissions offer, it's important for students and families to spend time researching financial aid options and pick a university that not only fits a student's academic profile, but their financial profile as well. Visit our website at viewpointsonline.net for links to financial aid resources and other helpful information. You can also follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Viewpoints Radio, and subscribe and listen to our show anytime wherever you listen to podcasts. This segment is written and produced by Annie Krall and Amira Zaveri. I'm Gary Price.
coming up next week.
The suburbs were never designed with sustainability in mind.
The challenges facing suburbia today. Then,
when you take on the role of being a bridesmaid, it's almost like you become an event planner and you're tasked with doing all these things when really you just want to be a good friend.
The hefty cost of being a supportive friend during wedding season. I'm Marty Peterson.
And I'm Gary Price. These stories in depth on your public affairs magazine, Viewpoints.